My name is J.V. Nayak. I am from CLU Abacus. CLU Abacus means Center for Learning Vedic Maths and Abacus. We teach both Abacus and Vedic Maths. Today, I am going to give you the class on Vedic Maths. For learning Vedic Maths, you require to know two things. What is Vedic Maths? How it has come? And what is the use of Vedic Maths? After learning Vedic Maths, what you are going to get, that is called use of Vedic Maths. First, I will give you the introduction to the Vedic Maths. So you might know the Vedas. There are four Vedas are there. The third Veda is Atharva Veda. In Atharva Veda, our Rishi Munis have given some mathematics. So that is why that Veda word has come. So our Vedas was written around about 3,500 years back. In 1911 to 1918, one Jagadguru Sri Bharati Krishnaji, he rewrote all those books. He came to Sringeri and 4 years he stayed there and he studied all that Vedic Maths, which was written in Vedas. And he discovered the Vedic Maths book. And he wrote 16 books over there on Vedic Maths. So each book was explaining different branches of the maths, algebra, trigonometry, calculus, arithmetic, like that. So in that book, there are 16 sutras. Sutras means formula. There are 16 formulas in Vedic Maths. And 13 upasutras. Upasutras means sub-formula. The combined name given to that 16 sutra and 13 upasutra is incorporated in one book that is called Vedic Maths book, which was written by, the man who wrote the Abacus Vedic Maths book is Jagadguru Sri Bharati Krishnaji. So by learning this Vedic Maths, you can do the maths very fast. So I'll give you an example. Suppose if you want to multiply 3-digit by 3-digit number, for example, 378 into 565. 378 into 565. In a normal math, what you are doing? First, you are multiplying with this 5. Then we'll multiply this 6. Then again, we'll multiply this 5. There will be 4 steps. Whereas in the Vedic math, we can write the answer only in one line. So you can, instead of writing these 4 steps, we can write the answer in only one line. That is the Vedic math. So I'll show you some examples also over there. So we can do, with the help of this Vedic math, we can do faster addition, subtraction, multiplication, square root, cube root, calculus, partial coefficient, and also many, all mathematics we can do very fast. So that is the Vedic Maths. So the Bharati Krishna, I told you, the Bharati Krishna wrote the Vedic Maths book, original book. So he, in some book, he wrote, Vedic Maths is a magic maths before you learn it. Vedic Maths is a fast maths after you learn it. Okay? Just by learning the Vedic Maths, you can improve your maths. So today, if we'll ask the students, 80% of the students will say the Vedic Maths is a very tough subject and a boring subject. And a lot of students have got maths phobia. Maths phobia means they were afraid of maths. By learning and practicing this about Vedic Maths, you can improve your maths. And you can avoid the maths phobia, and definitely it is going to be useful in your regular maths also. Then second comes, what is the use of this Vedic maths by learning and practicing Vedic maths, what you are going to get. So I'll give you an example. After this, your education and all, you're going for this engineering college entrance exam, IIT and all those things. There, I'll give an example of your CET exam. In CET exam, there will be 60 questions. You have to answer in 1 hour. It means one question is 1 minute. You have to answer in 1 minute. There will be the question and 4 answers will be given, and you have to take one answer, multiple choice question. Suppose if you know CET exam will be there in physics, chemistry, maths, and biology. In physics, chemistry, and biology, if you know the answer, you can take it. It means the 1 hour time is sufficient. Whereas in the maths, you can't get the answer directly, and they will not give you the calculator and all those things over that. I'll give an example. So one small question will be that one TV has purchased for 32,000 rupees and sold at 38,000 rupees. What is the percentage of profit? So directly you can't write the answer. So what you have to do is sale price minus purchase by divided purchase by into 100. All this calculation you have to do. Once you start to do all those calculations, minimum you require 2 to 3 minutes. If you know the Vedic maths, you can get the answer in less than 1 minute. The students who is getting 100 out of 100 in a regular maths, or not able, even not, he is not able to answer more than 45 to 50 questions. He will leave some 10 questions. If you know this Vedic maths, you can attempt all the questions in a CET exam and that type of examination. If you get one mark extra, your rank will go up around about 1,000 to 2,000. If you go into 10, if you get around about 10 marks extra, your rank will go 15 to 20,000 up. So there it is going to be useful much. So to train for that, we are teaching this Vedic maths from fifth standard itself. Okay, you can start learning the Vedic maths from fifth standard itself. So now I will give some example. With example, I will explain you what is the Vedic maths and how we can do the maths faster. So I'll explain you now, okay? So in a specific techniques, you cannot use the techniques for all the numbers. As a general technique, you can, that formulas you can use for all the numbers. First, I'll explain you some specific techniques, then I'll go for general techniques. Okay, I'll show that with the example, I'll explain how faster the Vedic maths is. So this is called multiplying any number by series of one. So here there may be any number. Here I should have only two ones, three ones, four ones, like that. That is called series of one. So here 54 into 11. So first you write this 5 here. Leave some there place and write this 4. So in the middle, just you add these two numbers. 5 plus 4 equals to 9. 5, 9, 4 is the answer. You need not multiply and write the answer. So, hope you are doing it. 54. One more method is done. Into one. First, you write this number as it is. 4. For second one, you add these two numbers. 5 plus 4, 9. You write the number 9. Third, you write this number as it is. This is the answer. Into 1, 1. Okay. First, you write this 8 as it is. Then, here there are two ones are there. So, you add these two numbers. 8 plus 6, 14. So, you have to write 14 in the 10th place. The carryover one, next digit down you have to write. Carryover one, next digit down. For the last number, 6 is there. 6, add this one, 7. See that. You need not directly multiply at all. I'll show you one 3-digit number. Here there may be any number. Here I should have only one series of one. 3, 4, 8, 6, 5 into 1, 1, 1. So first you write this number as it is. 5. So here how many ones are there? There are 3 ones. 5 plus 6, 11. So just add one here. The carryover one, next digit down. Here 3 ones are there. I have to go up to 3 numbers. 5 plus 6, 11. 11 plus 8, 19. And add this carryover on 20. Right, 0 here. The carryover 2 here. Give the last number and take next 3 numbers. That's 14 plus 4, 18. 16 plus 20. Right, 0 here. Carryover next 3 numbers. And leave one more number. Take next 3 numbers. 8 plus 4, 12. 12 plus 3, 15. 15 plus 2, 17. 7 here. Carryover 1. Leave this number. 4 plus 3, 7. 7 plus 1, 8. Leave this number, 3. This is the answer. So without multiplying any number directly, you can write the answer. 2, 5, 6, into 1, 1, 1. Okay, shall I do this number now? Then you add these two numbers, 6 plus 5. In 100 place down, you have to write. Here, three ones are there. I have to go up to three numbers. 6 plus 5, 11. 11 plus 2, 13. And add this carry over, 14. Right, 14. I have added three numbers here. Leave the last number. Take next three numbers. 5 plus 2, 7. 7 plus 8, 15. Add this carry over. Right, 6 here. The carry over 1 is here. And leave this last number. Take next three numbers. 2 plus 8, 10. 10 plus 3, 13. 13 plus 1, 14. 4 here. Carry over 1. 4 here. Carry over 1. Leave this number. 3 plus 7, 3 plus 8 plus 3, 11. 11 plus 1, 12. 2 here, carry over 1. 3, one more number. 3 is left over. 3, and is carry over 1, 4. This is the answer. 6 plus 5, 11. 1 here. 6 plus 5, plus 2. 6 plus 5, 11. Plus 2, 13. Plus 1, 4 I am writing here, carry over here. Multiplying any number by series of 9. Now you have learned multiplying the number with series of 1. Now I'll show you how to multiply the number series of 9. For example, 65 into 9, 9. So in this method, you know, we should have equal digits in both the place. So here two digits are there. Again, here two digits are there. I can do it. So whatever may be the number here, just reduce 1, is 65 is there. 65 minus 1 equal to 64. We write the answer 64. Why you wrote this 64 here? Here it's 65 there, minus 1, 64. Then subtract these numbers individually from 9. 9 minus 6, 3. 9 minus 4, 5. Is the answer. 7. So in a normal mass, what you do? Multiply with 9, leave one place. Again, multiply all this for 9, leave one two place. Again, 9. And add all those numbers. All those things you have to do. A lot of time is required. In Vedic mass, you can do it very fast. Both the sides, multiplicand and multiply. So to make it equal, to make this two digit number, three digit number, I'm adding 1 0. So value not changing. If you write a 0 left side of any number, that number is not changing. But it's a three digit number. So whatever may be the number, just minus 1. So 0, 8, 2. From 0, 8, 3, minus 1, 0, 8. So now I'll throw in a squaring of number. You know what is in a squaring? Suppose if you multiply the same number twice, it is called square of that number. So this formula, squaring of number ending with 5. Squaring of numbers ending with 5. Okay. Suppose if you want to square this 35. Square of 35. How we are doing the square of 35? 35 into 35. In our normal mass. So 5 5s are 25. 2. 5 3s are 15. 15 plus 2, 17. We leave one place here. 3 5s are 15. 3 3s are 10. 10 plus 1, 11. And we'll add 5, 2,
3, 1. 1 carry, sir.
Five, 15, 25, 2, 15, 17. Leave one place here. 3 5s are 15, 1. 3 3s are 9, 9 plus 1, 10. Add them. 5, 2, 2, 1. The square of 35 square equal to 1,225. The answer, well, normal math. But Vedic mass will not do all these calculations. Directly we'll write the answer. 3 plus 1, this is the first number. 3 plus 1, 4. And 4 multiply by the whole number. 3. 4 is 12. Right, 12. And square the last number, 5. 5 5 is 25. So same answer. Suppose if you want to square 65, 45. What is this number? 4. add 1 to that. 4 plus 5. 5 into 4, 20. 5, 5 is 25. Square of 45 is 2025. Like that, you have a revision. Suppose if you want to call 75 square. What is the number here? 7. Add 1 to that. 8. 8 into 7. 56. And square this number, 5. 5 5s are 20. Suppose you want to square 54 square. So first you should have last number 5. Here the first number 5. Here 5 5s are 25. And add this number. 25 plus 4, 29. And square the last number, 4 4s are 16. The square of 54 is 2916. So like that, you are doing. Now I'll show you one division method. Okay, that will be very easy. 2, 3, 1, 2 divided by 2, 3, 1, 2 divided by 9. So 9, 2, 7, 18, 5, 1. 9, 5, 7, 45, 6, 2, 9, 6, 7, 54. This is called multiplicand. No, this is a dividend. This is called divisor. This is the answer, quotient. And the left out is remainder. In a division problem, dividend, divisor, quotient, and remainder. So in a Vedic maths, we will not do all these steps. So these steps you will not do. Directly, you will get dividend and the divisor. Directly, you can write quotient and remainder. I'll show you how to write. 2, 3, 1, 2 divided by 9. Directly, I'll write the quotient. See now, very much interesting. How many digits are here? If your dividend has got, for the second digit, just you add these two numbers. 2 plus 3, 5. 5 plus 1, 6. 6 plus 2, 8. In a normal mass, you have to do all the steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, sixth step, you got the answer. Can you hear me? 86. 4, 3, 8, 6 divided by 9. So, you write the answer directly. Three digits. I have one more radio. Three. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I got a 5 digits. And in a quotient, I get only 4 digits. For the first digit, you write this number as it is 3, as it is 3. For second digit, you have this two number, 3 plus 4. For third digit, you have this three number, 3 plus 4, 7, 7 plus 3, 10. Write 0 here, the carry over 1, below 7. For the next digit, 3 plus 4, 78. 10 plus 8, 18, 8 here, 0, 8, 3. Reminder is the question. Reminder, you add all the numbers. 3 plus 4, 7, 7 plus 3, 10, 10 plus 8, 18, 18 plus 6, 24. But you know that the remainder should not be more than divisor. The remainder is 24, divisor is 9. So 9 ones are 9, 9 twos are 18, 9 threes are 27. So the 9 twos are 18. 6 here. So 6 is less than 9, so I can have it. I have taken out 18 here. 18 means 2 nines. So the 2 you add 3, 8, 2, 0. The quotient. Important sutra is called crisscross method of multiplication. It is called Urudhvatiryaka Sutra. So any number, any multiplication number, you can do with the help of this. I'll show that one now. So I draw a simple number first. 32 into 12. Okay, how you are doing it now? 32 in a normal mass, 12. 32 into 4,
3s are 6, 1 2s are 2, 1 3s are 3. And as this number, 4, 8, 3. 4, 8, 3. This is a normal mass you are doing. But I'll show you how to do in a Vedic mass. In Vedic mass, always you will write the number one below the other. 32 and 12. So you write the number one below the other. Okay. So I'll show you some stars and the any four number. So multiply the last two numbers first. What are the last two numbers? 2 and 4. 2 into 2 is equal to 2 and 4. So this is the unit place answer first. For 10th place answer, four numbers are cross multiply and add them. What are those numbers cross multiply and add? 3 into 2 plus 2 into 1. 6 plus 2 is equal to 8. So 8 is the answer, second answer. For the last number, multiply the last two numbers. The last two, 3 and 1. 3 into 1 is equal to 3. The same answer here. 3, 8, 4. 384 and 24. So now I'll give some higher numbers, okay? Multiply the last two numbers. You can directly be clear. 4, 3 are 12. So write 2 here. The carry over 1, next is it down. Carry over always you have to write next is it down. This is the first. Multiply the last two numbers. And second one. 6, 3 are 46. And I got one carry over it. 47. Write 7 here. The carry over 4. Don't have it. Now multiply the last two numbers. These two numbers. 6, 7 are 42. And add this 4. 42 plus 4, 46. This is the answer. So directly in one line, you can get the answer. So this is 2 digit by 2 digit. Now I'll show you one more. 3 digits, 312 multiplied by 204. Here's it, 3 digit by 3 digit. So write the number one below the other. 312 204. So I'll draw some. These are any four numbers. Okay, start. So first multiply the last two numbers. 2 4s are 8. For second one, cross multiply and add the last two numbers. 1 4s are 4. 2 0s are 0. 4 plus 0 is equal to 4. That is 4. Now I multiply two numbers. Second, I multiply this set of two numbers. Third, I multiply set of these three numbers. Now leave the last number and take only this 4. Leave the last one. Multiply these two numbers. 3 0s are 0 plus 2 1s are 2. 0 plus 2 is 2. 1 carry over there. So right. And this is also over. Now only last one set in, that's all. Multiply those. 3 2s are 6. So 63,648 is the answer. So you need not do any calculation. Directly you can write that. This is a base number. 1000 is a base number. 10,000 is the base number. 1 lakh is the base number. Suppose the given numbers are near to the base number, you can go for this method. It is a very easy method. Suppose if you want to multiply 98 into 97. Okay, you want to multiply 98 into 97. So then, one below the other. 97. So what is the base number for this? The 98. 98 and 97 are near to 100. On top, I am writing 100. Now, you have to find out the deviation. Deviation means how much our number is deviating from the base number. So, here, my number is 98. It is 2 less than the base number. see that I'm writing minus 2. 100 minus 2 equal to 98. Similarly, the next number is 97. How much it is less than 100? 3 number less than 100. Minus 3. Sign that kind of like this. So how many zeros are there in this base number? 2. So your right side left, you will have 2 digit number. I have to put 2 dash in. Multiply this deviation equal to 6. 6 is a single digit number. So you have to write 06. Suppose cross addition or subtraction you do, that is 98 minus 3 or 97 minus 2, you get the same answer, which is 95. So remove this standard time. First order, though, you take the deviation, means how much it is less than 100. I have written the 100 here. It is 2 less, here it is 3 less. I am writing minus 2 and minus 3. But a slanted line is, so base has got 2 zeros. So you have to put 2 dash here. Because right side you should have 2 digit number. So multiply the deviation, 2 into 3, equal to 6. But 6 is a single digit number. So write 06. Yeah. In the left side, 98 minus the cross, you add a subtract, 97 minus 95. So remove this line, 95, 06 is the answer. I'll show you one more. If the given number is more than the base, suppose if you want to multiply 107 into 103. So how much it is more than 107 is more than 100. The more is there, I am writing plus 7. 103 plus 3. Same method. Two zeros are there. Multiply this deviation. 7 into 3 equal to 21. So earlier I had a minus sign, so I was subtracting it. Now I have got a plus sign here. I have to add it. 103, 107 plus 5 equal to 110. 103 plus 7 equal to 110. Both answers will get the same. So you write 110. Remove this line. 110, 21. Thanks. The deviation is here you see 107 is there. 107 is 7 more than 100. So I'm writing 7 here. And here I am writing 3. Multiply this number. 7 into 3 equals to 21. That one I have to write in the right side. At the right side, left side answer, you cross add any one number. Both the numbers will get the same answer. 107 plus 3 or 103 plus 7. So 110. Remove this line. 110, 21 is the answer.
Okay.
And one more answer. 5 into 985. What is the base for this? 1,000. So how much it is less than 1,000? 5 less than 1,000. Minus 5. How much this is less than 1,000? 1,000 minus 988, 15. So minus 15. Standard line. How many zeros are there? 3. So I have to put 3 dash here. 1, 2, 3. So multiply these two numbers. Minus 5 into minus 15. Minus 5 into minus 15 into plus 75. But I should have 3 digit numbers. So write 0, 70, 0, 0, 75. So 995. Multiply by 985, you get 980,075. So very easy, na? Example is that crisscross is a very, that's a general method. You can apply for any number. Once again, one more example I show you in the crisscross only, okay? 45 into 38. You have to multiply 45 into 38. Three steps. Huh? First, what you do? Multiply the last two numbers. 4, 8 are 32. 5, 3 are 15. Add them. 47. And 4 carry over is that. 47 plus 4, 51. Write 1 year. The carry over 5. Next digit. Now, the third step. Multiply the last two numbers. 4, 3 are 12. 12. Plus 5, 17. 45 into 38 equal to 1,710. So directly you can get the answer in one line. Suppose if you multiply, so multiply all the numbers, three steps you have to do like that. In Vedic maths, there are 6 levels. So all these chapters, we have made it 6 levels. So we are teaching from 5th standard. So if you're in centers, if you learn it, one level will be for 3 months. So
to complete all full course, you required 8, 1.5 years is